It flows real nice. The cattle go up in and they come right back where they come from. It takes a minimal amount of people to work, and it's a very safe system for the animals and for the human. It's all open-sided, so it works real nice. It's pretty portable. And with that amount of cattle, from 25 to 100 head of cattle, it seems to work real well. You get a lot of work done in a day. What we're using here is a 180-degree open-sided sweep with a 32-foot lead-up alley. It's all open-sided, so you want to make sure and not have too much movement up at the front of the chute. Everybody needs to keep their movement slow and easy like we should anyway, but it's real critical with an open-sided system. There's a lot of room to put quite a few cows in, but you don't want to overcrowd it. Five cows in a 30-foot, 2-foot alley of the size we were working is just about right.
This is what we call the rancher chute, which is, gives us the option of manual operation or automatic. If you and I are out here working cattle, you're pushing cattle to me or vice versa, I'm always going to use a manual because I think I can catch and release more cattle on manual than you can on any automatic. I use the automatic when I'm by myself. I've got to go back there and get a cow runner up, and I need that self-catch option. So this is the head gate that does that. Of course, the cow can't have horns on any automatic or any self-catching head gate. All of them work on the principle that the head's smaller than the shoulders. Set the opening just wide enough for the head, narrow enough for the shoulders, go back, hit her, she sees the daylight and trips it.
So for the mid-size, medium-sized farmer or rancher, what should they look for in a squeeze chute?
Well, Kurt, I think the durability is always something to look for a squeeze chute, because you know, whether you're running 100 head or 1,000 head, they break one head at a time, you know. So we have to make even our more economical model, which is this rancher chute, durable enough and sturdy enough to handle any of the cattle that might come through it, whether it be a cow, calf, bull, whatever. It has to be safe for the operator and the animal. We've done several things to this chute to make it a little safer. One of the things I really like about it from the cattle standpoint, though, is our contoured sides. You notice when you squeeze those cows, you kind of get around them, and you're not putting as much stress on the rib cage. It kind of holds them up a little bit. They don't have as much tendency to go down. You're containing them, but you're not stressing them as much. I think it's important for an individual to go look at several of them, talk to his neighbors, talk to other people that are knowledgeable, find the chute that fits them the best.
Is this chute portable?
It is portable. We actually have an axle that we can put on this chute and some brackets to the front, and we have a portability carriage that a guy no bigger than me, I can come out by myself and load this chute up on that carriage and hook it up the back of my truck and go to my next place, operate. I don't know of another single chute that I can do that with.
The nice thing about this system is when we get done working, we can take it down very quickly in about half hour, 45 minutes. A pretty nice small flatbed trailer, and you could haul it to the next facility or somebody else's outfit. If you're going to build a facility, it's also nice to kind of have a portable system to use to make sure everything works right. Before you put things in concrete or lay a base down, set it up, try it portable, kind of not so permanent at first. If you really like it, then go to it and set her in the ground.